this, you ready?
All right, so I'm sure all of you have heard the term, or the saying, natural is always better. But in the case of medicine, that's not necessarily true. There are a variety of different alternative medicines, is what they're called, and it goes from anywhere from chiropractic to sound therapy. In this speech, I'll be talking to you a little bit about what alternative medicine is, why it is a problem, and how we can solve the problem. This is a Logan production. The Merriam-Webster online dictionary defines alternative medicine as any various systems of healing or treating disease that are not included in the traditional curricula taught in the medical schools of the United States and Britain. Now, in layman's terms, it's something that's not taught in med school. So it's kind of, it's almost like somebody just walks in and, you know, they get taught how to do something. Well, for example, sound therapy. The people who are experts in this, sound therapy is where they make sounds at the body. So it sounds a little bit along the lines of mop, and they yell at your chest or whatever. And it's really stupid, just so you know. But to be a certified sound therapist, you show up at some business and you go through like 3 or 4 classes, and then all of a sudden you're able to charge people $148 to yell at their body and heal them. And here are a few more. There's Ayurveda, and it's 3,000 years old, which always is great when you're talking about medicine, because apparently if it's old, it still works. But it's basically where you cleanse your body of toxins, and that's really all it is. And so the next one is Reiki, and it's aimed at manipulating the aura, and there is no aura. Sorry to break it to you people, but there's no scientific evidence that shows that human beings have an aura of any kind. And then, yeah, the sound therapy thing, which is absolutely crazy. Some of you who were in Health Science 1, freshman year probably, Doyle probably showed you a video of sound therapy. I don't know if you guys recall that, but all right, so now I'll move on to why it's problematic. Now, the issue when it comes to alternative medicine is that it's not FDA approved, or it doesn't go through the proper channels of testing that modern medicines go through, which means that they can put out anything that they want, and there's no repercussion for them. They can sell it for whatever price they want, and I mean, it just has to be non-toxic to the body. But it doesn't have to help. And this here is from a report from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, and it kind of states a few of the problems that they have seen. Like, there's no way to standardize it, like it says right here, because there is no oversight committee on it or whatever. There's no way to make sure that everybody's doing the same thing, and they don't have to follow protocols that for like sterilization and stuff like that that normal medical facilities would have to go through. All right, so now let's talk about how we can solve this problem. We need to be cautious about using alternative medicine. Bill Nye, in his new show, Bill Nye Save the World, gave us a few of the red flags we can look out for. We can look for the use of dramatic stories. So if it says that you know, somebody had cancer and then they drank peppermint oil or whatever and that cured them, it's a mysterious cure-all, But we all know that that wouldn't work, right? Because there's no way that peppermint oil could cure cancer. It can claim to cure everything, which would be fantastic, but altogether not possible. If it invokes ancient wisdom, a lot of the places that you can go to receive alternative medicine or alternative therapies or anything along those lines, they'll have a lot of religious iconography, like the Buddhas, and they'll have like four or five of them spread out throughout their entire office, but they don't have anything related to Buddhism. So you need to like look out for those kind of things. And it can also have that kind of thing on the bottle or something like along those lines. Like if it has it on the bottle itself, like a religious symbol, then it's probably not going to help you. Ambiguous cultural references. If you go to Whole Foods, I guarantee you can find a lot of these. Actually, I probably can't say Whole Foods because it's copyrighted. So we can't put this on YouTube. If it claims that it's somehow natural, it's better. And I've already covered this, or uses the phrase, what doctors don't want you to know. And this is crap because everybody knows that doctors just want you to get better. That's what they get paid to do. There's not some big pharma conspiracy. They are there to make you feel better, and they enjoy doing that, otherwise they wouldn't do it. And so and we also need to research some of these treatments that they're going through, so we can either prove them as a hoax or create them into new medicine. There's this old joke in the medical research community that says, what do you call an alternative medicine treatment that works? You call it medicine. So I kind of covered what alternative medicine was and what the problem was with alternative medicine, and then how we can solve the problem. So I hope the next time you wind up in a health food store or something along those lines, that you are very cautious about what you buy, because they are all businesses that are trying to just make you buy things and not actually like there to make you feel better. Thank you.